गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम सुभाषिनी मुदलियार, गोइंग टू टीच यू मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. दिस इज सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द कंटेंट साइंस क्लास 10. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अबाउट द रिएक्शन ऑफ मेटल विद एसिड, वाटर एंड एयर. So let's start with the chemical properties of the metal, how the metals will react with oxygen. So see here, you know very well about the metals. That can you think about the examples of a metal? In the previous lecture, we have studied about the properties of metal and non-metal. So we have discussed about sodium, magnesium, aluminium, copper, zinc, right? So these are all metals. So let's start with the content. Almost all metals react with oxygen to form metal oxide. So when if it is a metal oxide, it is basic in nature. Basic in nature means what? It will turn the litmus paper blue color. It's a basic, right? So sodium and potassium are most reactive metals. That's why this it is kept in under kerosene or oil. It should not come in contact with the moisture which is present in the air, because it reacts vigorously. Sodium reacts with oxygen in air at a room temperature to form sodium oxide. Hence, sodium is stored under a kerosene oil to prevent its reaction with the oxygen. Okay, one more thing I want to tell you about the diatomic molecules, which will help you in balancing the equation. Suppose if we are writing oxygen, we know the symbol of oxygen, that is O. Here we have taken O2 because it's a diatomic molecules. So you just note it down: chlorine Cl2, bromine Br2, iodine I2, oxygen O2, nitrogen N2, hydrogen H2. These are all diatomic molecules. So when you will write this diatomic molecule in a equation, you always write in a O2, H2, N2 form only. Fine. So in 9th standard, you have studied about the valencies. The valency of sodium, magnesium, zinc. So just recall it. So once when sodium reacts with oxygen, it forms sodium oxide. Oxygen, from oxygen it turns to oxide. So this is what it forms, a metal oxide. So valency is O is O minus 2, Na is Na plus, it will cross down, so it is form Na2O, sodium oxide. For balancing, 2 times into 2, 2 to 4, so 4 Na and oxygen 2O. This is balanced equation of metal. When reacts with oxygen, gives metal oxide. You can take any metal like magnesium, zinc, potassium, any metal you can take and we will write the example. Most metal oxides are insoluble in water, but some of these dissolve in water to form alkalis and are basic in nature. Right now I told it's what is basic oxide means. What is basic in nature mean? It turns the litmus paper blue. So sodium oxide Na2O, potassium oxide K2O dissolves in a water to form alkali. Let's do the example. Sodium oxide, that is Na2O, when reacts with water, H2O, gives what? NaOH. Now there is a valency Na plus and hydroxide is OH minus. So plus minus will be same. So compound form, it's a NaOH. So for balancing, it is written 2. Same over here, potassium oxide reacts with water gives potassium hydroxide. These both are alkali and it is basic in nature. Let's talk about the magnesium. Magnesium does not react with oxygen at a room temperature. Yes, when we keep open the magnesium strip, it will not react. But on heating, when you apply some heat, it burns in the air with intense light, like a glowing spark. It will burn and heat to form magnesium oxide. So what is the reaction over here? Magnesium, when reacts with oxygen, oxygen always O2, gives magnesium oxide. Zinc burns in air only on a strong heating. If you will keep in a front of a Bunsen burner, it will take some time, and if more strong is there, then it forms zinc oxide. Iron, you can take iron rod, right? And it does not burn even on strong heating. But iron filling means what? Powder form of iron. Burns vigorously when sprinkled in the flame of a burner, that is, it gives iron oxide, Fe3O4, right? So these are all the metal when reacts with oxygen. Let's go ahead, just see here how magnesium, when comes, this is the magnesium strip, see here magnesium strip, when comes in a contact with the Bunsen burner, it ignites and shows like a bright light. So you can write over here, magnesium Mg plus O2 gives 2MgO, right? Copper is least reactive. It does not burn, but on heating, it gives a black colored layer of copper oxide because it's the least reactive. I will teach you about the reactivity series. Copper plus O2 oxygen gives CuO. So you need to remember the color of copper oxide is black. Aluminium develops a thin oxide layer when it comes in contact with the air. So aluminium plus oxygen on heating, it gives Al2O3. What is Al2O3? It's a aluminium oxide. Al is Al plus 3, valency Al plus 3, oxygen is O minus 2. So Al2O3 will come, fine. See here how copper, when comes in contact with the oxygen, gives copper oxide. Here copper is there, oxygen is in the form of O2. So this copper reacts with oxygen, gives copper oxide. This copper reacts with oxygen. This occurs on heating, gives copper oxide. It's as a result least reactive. It takes time. Next, there is a reaction of metal with water. As you know, group 1, sodium, potassium, are vigorously reacts when it comes in contact with the water, cold water. It's an exothermic reaction. What is exothermic reaction? When heat is given out, sodium reacts with water to evolve hydrogen gas. See here the equation. Sodium, when comes in contact with the water, gives sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen and it releases energy. That is heat energy. So basically we will tell as a exothermic reaction. See here, potassium reacts with water. How the molecules of the water effect. See here the reaction of sodium with the water. We have added sodium in a small particle and you can see the reaction over here. Let's see over here properly. As you have seen, The small amount of sodium is kept over here as it comes in contact with the cold water. It just gives a spark, and this is not possible in the lab. It should be done in a industrial level. In the open place only the experiment can be done. Let's go next topic. Metal reacts with water again. It's only the sodium and potassium is a highly explosive or vigorously reaction. Calcium reacts with water less vigorously, and what it produces, it produces all metal when reacts with water gives hydrogen gas when released. Instead of calcium starts floating because the bubbles of hydrogen gas form stick to the surface of the metal. We have taken the other example also, magnesium that reacts with the hot water form magnesium hydroxide, that is MgOH twice. Why OH twice is there and here NaOH, only NaOH is there? Because of the valency. Calcium is Ca plus 2, hydroxide is OH minus, so CaOH twice, and here magnesium is Mg plus 2, OH is OH minus, so MgOH twice. See here the other example also. Aluminium when reacts with water gives aluminium oxide, not hydroxide. Fine, aluminium oxide. Why? Because in the balancing equation it is not coming properly as hydrogen is releasing. So Al plus 3, O minus 2, Al2O3, and see here oxygen is 3, oxygen is 3, hydrogen is 6, 3 to the 6, so 3 to the 6, aluminium is Al2. This way you will do the balancing of the equation. Reaction of metal with acids. Metal reacts with acid to give salt and hydrogen gas. Dilute hydrochloric acid, that is the HCl. So reactivity decreases in the order, like magnesium is more reactive than aluminium, and then aluminium is more reactive than zinc. Zinc is more reactive than Fe. See here, magnesium, aluminium, zinc and Fe all reacts with acid. So when it is reacting with the acid, gives salt plus hydrogen. So all chlorine, all sulfate, all nitrates, metal nitrates are salt. See here, magnesium. How you know magnesium chloride or magnesium hydride you have to make? Magnesium is Mg plus 2. Chlorine is Cl minus. So Mg and chlorine, plus and negative, positive and negative will react to form the salt. Mg is Mg plus 2, Cl is minus. So MgCl2, same over here, Al plus 3 and Cl minus gives AlCl3. Zn plus 2 plus Cl minus gives ZnCl2, like that only. Fine. And in the copper, copper is least reactive, as you know very well, it doesn't form any hydrogen gas. Now the same metal when reacts with a different acid, you know the acids, right? HCl, H2SO4, HNO3, these are the different kinds of acid which metals can be reacted. So metal when reacts with sulfuric acid gives iron sulfate. So iron reacts vigorously and exothermically with sulfuric acid to produce iron sulfate, because H2SO4 is a king of the acid. So when we use the sulfuric acid, we need to keep it mined more properly. Okay, the another example of the metal when reacts with acid. Here they have taken an example of any metal reacts with HNO3, that is nitric acid, gives magnesium nitrate, that is a salt, plus hydrogen, again Mg plus 2 and NO3, NO3 minus, HNO3 H plus, NO3 minus. So obviously here, so 2 will go here, 1 will go here, like Mg NO3 twice. It's a magnesium when reacts with nitric acid gives magnesium nitrate plus hydrogen. See here, when metal strip, this is a magnesium strip, when reacts in acid, you can take any acid in a form of dilute, the bubble, you can see that it comes from the metal. So it releases The gas. Which gas? Which bubbles? It's a hydrogen gas, right? You can collect it using the displacement tube also. See here. This one is a metal. When comes in contact with the oxygen, it gives magnesium oxide. This we can do in the lab, right? So here they have taken a example of a magnesium. When comes in contact with the air, it shows magnesium oxide. So this is the chart. You can able to understand the element name, how it reacts with the air, water and acid. So these two are different and other rest are same. It is vigorously bonds to form oxide. It reacts with cold water and gives hydrogen gas and alkaline hydroxide, and reacts with decreasing vigor down the series till calcium. And what about here? As sodium reacts with acid, it gives salt and hydrogen gas. It's a violent reaction. Fine. So as you know very well, we have discussed about the reaction of the air, water and acid with the metals. In the next lecture, we will continue. Hope you understood the lecture very well. Thank you. Have a nice day.